This is STEM Looks Like Me by Amber Booth McCoy,
Katina Booth White,
and Cortney Booth Akers.
This book came from an idea that we had after creating a STEM camp for K through 8th graders.
We wanted to create a book that showed representation, diversity, and identities within STEM careers. Yep. It's a beautiful summer day. Mrs. Booth stands in the doorway as the big yellow school bus stops in front of her home. Seeing her happy children, Amber and Alex, exit the bus brings a huge smile to her face. "Good afternoon, my loves," she says, as she greets her smiling twins with after-school hugs and kisses. "I can't wait to hear all about my favorite fourth grader's day," she exclaims. "Now, wash your hands and meet me at the kitchen table for a snack." Alex and Amber hurriedly set down their backpacks and rush to the bathroom to do as Mama instructed. "Make sure to get them very clean," Mama reminds them. Excited about their day, the two race to the kitchen, eager to share their day with Mama. Mrs. Booth places a plate with yummy snacks on the table. "So," she begins slowly, "you know what I want to know." Alex quickly speaks. "I know. You want to know who we helped today," Amber adds, "and you want to know what we learned."
Mama nods her head in agreement. She asks the same questions every day after school since her children were kindergartners. Their conversation is what makes snack time so special. "It's your turn to go first," Amber says to her brother. Alex thought for a minute and said, "I helped Miss White put up supplies after the class science experiment." "That's very kind of you, son," Mama says, kissing him on the forehead. "Your turn, sis," Alex says to Amber. "Today in class, Miss White taught us about the color black," Amber informs their mom. "What's so special about the color black?" Mama asks her daughter. "The color black is very important in STEM," Amber responds quickly. "There are places in space called black holes. There's a special color called Vanta black, and so much more," Alex shares enthusiastically. "STEM," Mama smirks. "Do you mean like the stem on a leaf?" Amber and Alex laugh, shook their heads no, and then in unison said, "STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math." "That's exactly right," Mama says proudly. There had been many previous conversations about the importance of STEM, and she was happy to know the children were learning so much. "I want to be a scientist, Mama," Amber said with excitement. "Me too, Mama," Alex agreed with enthusiasm. Mama laughed. Her children's enthusiasm was infectious. "I think that's wonderful," she told them. "You're both smart and amazing. I know you will make great scientists. What kind of scientist will you be? What kind of science do you like best?" Amber and Alex looked puzzled. "I don't know," Amber said slowly. "What kinds of scientists are there?" Alex asked his mother. "Don't worry," Mama said as she got up from the table. "I've got just the book for you to share." She went into their home library and returned with a large book. "The world of science is huge," she told them. "This book will help you learn more about the different types of science and scientists," Mama says, holding the book in front of the twins. Alex says, "Hey, they look," and Amber interjects, "just like me." "They sure do," Mama agreed. Alex and Amber eagerly began exploring their new book.
A, archaeologists. An archaeologist studies the past of humans. Sometimes this includes digging through the dirt.
B, biomedical engineer. A biomedical engineer develops tools and devices to improve human health.
C, chemist. A chemist investigates the properties of atoms.
D, data scientist. A data scientist uses graphs and charts to understand and explain things around them.
E, entomologist. An entomologist studies insects.
F, forensic scientist. A forensic scientist uses science to investigate crime.
G, geneticist. A geneticist is the study of DNA and how it affects our health.
H, hematopathologist. A hematopathologist examines body tissue and blood.
I, immunologist. An immunologist studies our immune systems.
J, Java developer. A Java developer creates applications using programming languages.
K, kinesiologist. A kinesiologist studies the way our body moves.
L, lab technician. A lab technician assists scientists with experiments.
M, meteorologist. A meteorologist studies and reports on weather and climate changes.
N, neurologist. A neurologist studies the way our central nervous system works.
O, oceanographers. An oceanographer studies the ocean.
P, pharmaceutical scientist. A pharmaceutical scientist researches and creates new medicines.
Q, quantum physicist. A quantum physicist studies the portions of the universe.
R, robotics engineer. A robotics engineer creates robots to help humans.
S, solar engineer. A solar engineer researches and designs solar panels that make energy from the sun.
T, taxonomist. A taxonomist groups and identifies organisms.
U, urban planner. An urban planner uses math and statistics to create plans for land and buildings.
V, veterinarian. Veterinarian cares for all types of animals.
W, water quality scientist. A water quality scientist is responsible for making sure our drinking water is safe.
X, X-ray technician. An X-ray technician takes pictures of the inside of a person's body to help diagnose disease or injury.
Y, you. You are an essential part of STEM.
Z, zoologist. A zoologist studies animals in the wild and held in captivity.
It looks like Mama was right after all, Alex Beans. There are many sciences to love, Amber agrees.
And STEM looks like me.
The two say proudly.